Settling slurry flows involve complex phenomena and need a sophisticated approach when it comes to their modeling. Modern measuring instrumentation is providing great insight and experimental data required for a calibration and validation of predictive models. The predictive models can serve as design tools for slurry transport system. Various modeling approaches are available. Modeling based on integral quantities and producing semi-empirical correlations. Modeling taking an internal structural flow into account and producing mechanism-based layered models. And modeling based on the use of computational fluid dynamics. There are two major predicted quantities for transport system design and operation. The first one is the frictional hydraulic gradient as a function of flow velocity. For the range of velocities, the relation gives a pipe characteristic curve for certain slurry in a pipe of a certain diameter. The second one is the deposition limit velocity, which is the lowest velocity at which the pipeline system should be operated. There are models available for a prediction of these flow quantities. For engineering practice, the predictive models must be calibrated and validated by experimental data. Different types of settling slurries exhibit different shapes of pipe characteristic curves within the range of flow velocities of practical interest. There are three basic types of settling slurry flow. At one extreme are large, rapidly settling particles. Their submerged weight cannot be carried by fluid support mechanisms and must be transferred to the pipe wall by intergranular contacts. When all particles behave in this way, the flow is fully solidified. The other limiting case is represented by the behavior found for fine sand slurries and known as pseudo-homogeneous flow. For this type of flow, the particles are carried by the fluid rather than by intergranular contacts. The intermediate case is known as heterogeneous flow, for which both intergranular contact and fluid support mechanisms are significant. A special case is flow of broadly graded solids in a Newtonian carrier, in which grains supported by different mechanisms interact with each other. In evaluating the frictional hydraulic gradient, settling slurry models typically use some dimensionless group, as for instance the relative solids effect RSE. It represents the extra friction loss caused by the conveyed solids, and it is related to other dimensionless groups, which are different for different types of settling slurries.